Hello guys, this is Inosa from Opportunity Hub. In this video, I'm going to talk about open scholarships in the UK, different scholarships which are open that you can apply right now. I think these are the last scholarship for this year, so I searched for important scholarships that I wish that anyone who is still looking for scholarship can just try for masters or PhD, so in different universities. So I'm going to go through all those universities. The first one is Chevening scholarships, Gate Cambridge, Rhodes scholarship for Oxford, and King's College scholarship. So there's a scholarship we are going to go through to see application, what are requirements, how to apply, and some tips that can help someone who is applying right now. So I appreciate everyone who is watching, who watch our video, who subscribed, or who give us comments or some advice either on this channel, on our website, which is opportunityhub.net, or also to our social medias. I really appreciate, and we are here for you, that we are working for you, so we appreciate if we get some good feedback. If it's your first time or you're not subscribed, please subscribe to our channel. That's a way to support Opportunity Hub, and also is supporting others, because when we are having much subscribers, YouTube will suggest our video to many students, and some will get information. So if you are watching, we really appreciate if you also subscribe. The first scholarship we are going to talk about is Gate Cambridge scholarship. Yeah, it's a scholarship, University of Cambridge. Yep, this is one of the most competitive scholarship, also because of the ranking of the university. So let's go through these scholarships, and I think many people can just try their best. Okay, the first, let's see who can apply for this scholarship. First of all, you have to be an international student, not from United Kingdom, and you are applying for either PhD, masters, or just 1 year post graduate course. So you can have PhD or doing masters, or you're just doing 1 year postgraduate. These below are programs which are not eligible for this scholarship. Another point, let's see criterias. What we are looking for, so to get this scholarship, so first of all, you are academically excellent. As all we know, Cambridge is one of the best university in world, so you have to be good academically. Your bachelor has a nice grade, your master's, especially for someone having like a first class. So this is what they say, what they mean. I don't think if it will be possible to get through with second class or raw class, so people for with first class, this is the first criteria. Okay, at any class you can just choose, but make sure if there are many people with good grades, they will be the best. Reason for choosing the course. This is part of motivation, so you explain why you choose this course, why you choose this project. If it's a PhD, so you have to explain this in your motivation, so you make sure you have a good motivation and it's explaining why and the reason behind your choice. a commitment to improve the lives of others sees this is a part of also in your motivation letter. So you have to explain how you use your knowledge and how it will get an impact not only on you but also for your community. Leadership capacity, this is also you show in your motivation how which leadership position you ever occupied. So it doesn't have to be politics, that it's just your leadership, how you have been student leader, you have been in any clubs, you have been any organization, you have been a leader, you have team leader, you have just have occupying any kind of leadership position. So you can just put, you don't have to be that big, you have to even small one, but you explain how important was that position. This are not for ratio PhD to masters, that means they just try to take PhD and masters, so they don't just today this year they take only masters or PhD, so they make an attribution of 2/3. So that is the ratio, and so if you are masters or PhD, they just try to make equal, they just make some ratio, not taking only one category. Okay, when to apply for this scholarship? For United States citizen, this is the deadline for them, so we have to be September, application will be open in September. Deadline will be in October. So other things will be in between till January 2022, that they will getting a notification, and after the notification you have 72 hours to accept the offer. So that means they send you an email, you say, hey, you get a scholarship, and they are waiting for you to respond in 72 hours, so just a few days. If they don't get from you, they just give to another person. Other countries, so the deadline is almost the same, but it's the notification will be between, will be in March, so the same, you will wait for 72 hours. So you see, for someone who is thinking to apply, application now in August, in September it will be open. It's open now because you are already in September, and depending on your program, deadline will be between December and January, so it's time to prepare everything. So the department will do ranking or shortlisting December to February, so end of February there will be a notification for the award. So this is important dates. Let's see the last point, how to apply. So there will be part of admission application. Yep, so there's a form which combine everything, funding and admission. So for admission section, can check on the website what they need. For the funding section, also get important document you have to submit for your funding request. Admission request is just based on your academic ability. Then funding, they will look for your statement performance. So how you explain what you want, why, and it's have to be between 500 to 3,000 characters. So you have to respect this, and you explain everything. Explain why you choose the program, your readership capacity, how they be the impact, why you choose the program. So this is what you have to be this. And for PhD students, you have to share also research proposal. For masters or postgraduate, you don't need. Then another point is the reference. So you have to choose where reference, who the people will write reference for you, and who can write a reference to a student. So first of all, you ask someone who really knows you and they have been, maybe is your former employer, lecturer, supervisor, people who are connected to you professionally or academically. Another scholarship is Rhodes Trust Scholarship. It's scholarship for Oxford University in UK. It's one of big and well-known scholarship. So wherever you go, you can find information on this scholarship. There are many scholars, it's there for a long time, and it's known everywhere. So it's a nice scholarship. If you are interested in masters, you can just try this scholarship. Our informations are here. One thing I like for this scholarship, they give, you see on their website, their testimonial for scholars or winner, how we can say, or students. They just give information on almost everything. Just sharing their experience, how to make to do your application, how to make your motivation, everything. So it's best option for me if I'm going to apply for this scholarship. Take time, you listen their experience, how they do things and what tips they are giving, then this will help you to prepare your scholarship application. So there are many information you can check on this scholarship, and there are different kind of scholarship you can find here, which kind of scholarships they are for Kenya, for West Africa, for East Africa, for Asia. So there are many different kinds of Oxford scholarship in Rhodes. So you can just check also this scholarship. Okay, another scholarship is Chevening scholarship. So I made a full video on this scholarship, so I'm not going to take much time. Just telling people that it's still open for someone who is applying. So I put the link down in the description, just explaining how to apply for this scholarship. So this scholarship is open right now till October. So it's now time for collecting documents, checking everything, then you apply for this scholarship. So it's another scholarship, well-known scholarship. So this is the benefit. They pay university tuition fees, monthly spend, travel costs, arrival allowance, and this home hours, cost of visa application, travel grant. So it's a very nice scholarship and a well-known scholarship, and of course it's so competitive, but it's doable. So they take many people, and there is a geographical distribution. So they take certain number of people in one country, in another country, so you are having a chance. And it's for many countries. So if you are interested and you're not yet started checking this scholarship, please check it out and start your application. We made a video, I explained more about this scholarship, how to apply and everything. So please go there and search for this scholarship. Okay, the next scholarship is King College Scholarship, also known as PGR International Studentship 21-22. It's a PhD scholarship in different research areas. You can find here the type of scholarship. It's a full funded scholarship. It provides tuition fees, stipends, bench fees, and research guarantee or research fund. The small details or summary, this is for academic year 21-22. This is the grantee code, so we sit down where this code will be needed. This is a postgraduate research program. Deadline is 1st October 2021. So this is a time for application. So let's go down this scholarship. Let me just start with scholarship benefit. What does this scholarship covers? The first things, it's a full tuition fees, so you will not pay anything. They will pay tuition fees, annual stipend, which is 72,000. This is the highest stipend you can find for international student, especially in the UK. This is one of the best, and this is what sometimes made a scholarship really competitive. And there will be 5,000 for annual research cost, just annual, so depend on your program. So this is a full funded scholarship. You have a stipend, you have tuition fees, you have your research cost. Everything will be funded and at a good rate. This is one of the best scholarship that you have to give a try if you are eligible, of course. So we can just go up, we see which kind of program that are covered, so can do PhD study in one of those fields, so natural sciences and different medical courses and mathematics. So the duration of the program is 4 years, so up to 4 years. That means sometimes 3 or 4, but so you can do your research for 4 years. Number of scholarship, it's 9 scholarship that will be awarded. Starting time is 1st June 2022. So once you finish your application and you are taken, so you'll be ready to start next year in June. Yeah, let's check what about eligibility criteria. Yeah, to be eligible, the candidate must be, yeah, therefore, okay, you'll be paying tuition fees as international or overseas student. So that means you are international student. That's the first point. The second point, you have to be to apply for PhD program in King's College, London, and by 1st October. So you have to finish your application in one of programs below. Then you are available to start your program in June next year. You apply for studentship in King's College. So you have, first of all, to secure your place in university. By June 21, January 22, you have to be having your admission offer. So this is nice things because maybe now you are not having your IELTS or other or another English language certificate. So this is the time you can be having a conditional offer, then you will have a conditional by January. So there's time that you can plan it for your exam. Okay, please note, this is people who are not eligible. If you already started your PhD, you are not eligible. Distance learning, this is not eligible online. Professional doctoral or PhD, professional doctoral degrees are not eligible. Joint PhD and etc. So let's see how to apply, which is the most important point. Yeah, application process step. First of all, you have to get your supervisor. So it's your responsibility to check, to apply for. It's your responsibility to apply. So it's your responsibility to search for supervisor. So this is time when, if you are interested, it's time to start looking for supervisor. You start to text professors in King's College, and once you get your supervisor, that's the first point, then you start your application. And this is a crucial step in PhD application. So if you are interested, it's time for you to search for supervisor, then you agree with your search proposal. The second, once you get your supervisor, you make online application for admission at King's College. The deadline for application is 1st October 2021. So, and when your application, you have to use this code. So if you put this code, you are applying for admission, but they know he or she is applying for admission, but for this scholarship. So don't forget this. If you forget this, you may get your admission, but no scholarship. Then you apply for PGR International Studentship form. It's two different application. Point number four, you provide all your required document or supporting document for doctoral degree. So you check on the website, then you know which document they are needed. And you have to provide all those documents before the deadline. So there are more information, so you can just go down, you read this application form, conditions, yeah, how to prepare your motivation, how to prepare a search proposal, yeah. So you can just go down and search and read every doc, every important point down. So this is what about this scholarship. So for award details or just the calendar for schedule for this scholarship, since June, application is open. So since June, application is open for June next year. 1st October is deadline for admission application. 1st October is the deadline for admission application. So you have to make sure by 1st October you finish everything. Yeah, January, you have to be having your admission. So you have to finish everything with your university. Then by January 31st, you have your admission offer. And that will be the time for university to do a shortlisting. Then this will be the time for university for selection. First March, the decision will be announced. So by 1st March, you will know I get the scholarship or not. So this is about this scholarship. It's really competitive, but it's also doable. So if you are looking for PhD in UK, please, you can try this scholarship. Okay, let's continue with other scholarships.